So hey, awesome ones. Well, fall is officially here. And what I want to show you in this video is not just fashion tips, but also other ways that you can brace fall with makeup and other appearance tips. And it's my wish for you that at the end of this video, you're going to really want to embrace this season and be kind of excited about it. Are you ready? Let's go. So just before I get into this video, I want to tell you about me and fall, and I'm sure a lot of you can relate. I used to dread fall. I love the summertime, and then when it started getting colder, I think I actually suffered from SAD, which is seasonal affective disorder, and it's a real thing. If you're finding that you're really getting the blahs, you know, as soon as September or it's officially fall sets in, and it really gets bad, you might even want to see a doctor because it truly is a real thing. Now, what happened to me is I just kind of naturally got out of the blahs because I don't know about you, but our summers are so hot and humid right now, especially August, and it's kind of welcoming to feel those kind of cooler breezes, and also doesn't everybody just love the changing of the colors by Mother Nature? But let's get started on this video, starting with tip number one. And I'm also making sure in this video that I also include all of you women, all of you awesome ones that are living maybe 12 months out of the year in the warmer climates. So I'm making sure that this video is really like a layering type of video for fall, and that'll help you gals in the south as well and other warmer climates. Now, tip number one, I'm starting with a summery kind of look, and then I'm going to look how I transition it into fall. Let's take a look. So here I have one of my favorite kind of dressier summer looks, and I have this stretchy white pencil skirt. It's about $20 from Amazon, and I have a camisole underneath, and I also have this beautiful kimono, which I love. It's about $24 from Amazon. And you remember these fold-up Ray-Ban sunglasses? Absolutely love them. I can take them anywhere because they're fold up, and these kind of just top off my look. But let's take a look at a dressier kind of look for fall. So I kind of went all out with the yellow with the Pantone colors and also the rust skirt. This is the same skirt for $20 from Amazon. And again, it's stretchy. And you know, it's very nice weather, warm weather kind of look. But let's talk about the layering. I could put on a blanket scarf like this one here, which is square, but I made it into a triangle. And I'll just put this around like this if it's getting a little cooler. And there we go. I've got another kind of look. You can always flip it up this way too. Flip it up this way too if you want to be fancy. But also, what if it's really getting cold? Well, I have my Calvin Klein coat. It's like a camel coat. Absolutely love it. Let me just sort of put this around here a little bit. And it'll be a really nice finishing look here. This Calvin Klein coat, by the way, also from Amazon. And the top that I was wearing was about 28, the yellow top as well. So there you go. You got a nice layered look. So let's take a moment here to take a look at the Pantone colors, and these are for fall and also winter. And we see colors like a royal blue and illuminating yellow and greens and rusts and navy and even a sky kind of blue. And also included here are what they call kind of the core kind of neutrals. And you're seeing cream and also a moss color as well. And hey, by the way, if you are enjoying these videos and you're not a subscriber, well, come on down. Don't forget to subscribe. It really, really helps my channel out. And don't forget also to click on the bell. But I was talking about some neutrals, and of course, neutrals are still going to be big for wearing in the fall. But let's see a little bit of a transition from more of a warm, summery day to the fall. So here I am in a warmer weather look, and I just took this t-shirt. I need a little bit of ruching around my belly here, and I tied it in a knot, and I have a pair of beige neutral pants on. But let's take a look at how we can kind of dress this up and layer it up for fall. Now what I did here was I took the knot out and I just sort of tucked this t-shirt in both sides. And let's say I just want to warm up a little bit. I have this color, camel colored cardigan, and I got it from Nordstrom's a couple of years ago. So it looks really nice as a neutral on. And a lot of you are asking, well, you know, what about the leopard and animal prints? And as long as you're wearing them sparingly, yes, you can still wear them. So I would add a scarf to this, and I've got kind of a nice new neutral look going on. But let's say that the weather outside is frightful. I want to wear my Calvin Klein trench coat, and it's very weatherproof. And I'll just sort of put this on here. I just love this. It's $125 from Amazon. And isn't that a great look? And the other thing I love about this is this has a detachable, I don't know if you can tell so much. Oh, you know what? I'll just throw it on here. It has a detachable rain hoodie. So I just absolutely love that as well. And it doesn't matter whether it's snowing or raining, I'm going to be really ready for any weather. And don't touch that dial. Stay tuned till the end of this video, because my little Yorkie Hurricane, he's going to make a little cameo appearance, and I know a lot of you have been missing seeing him. Okay, so let's get on to the next look with a little presto change-o, and this is one that we can definitely get from our closets. So you can't go wrong on a warmer fall day with a look of white and black. It's so classic. And all I did, and yes, you can wear white pants in the fall, absolutely. These pants are from Ruby Road, and they're usually around $40 or $50, but they're on sale right now for $20 from Amazon. And don't forget, of course, I'll have the links for you in the description and also in the comments. And I added what's really trending right now, and that's a zebra scarf, and it's about $14. And let's see how we can start layering this look for when it gets a little chilly outside. So an idea if it's a chillier day is to wear, of course, a black blazer. And you'll notice that a lot of the coats and even blazers are getting a little longer in style. It seems to be a bit of a trend right now. And look at how elegant and put together this looks with, again, the classic white and black. And if I want to change it up a little bit with a scarf, I could do something like this as well. And it just makes it just a touch more dressier. Oh, and by the way, I almost forgot. Notice the shoes. The shoes are more of a neutral color instead of me going for a black shoe. And that way it adds a little bit of length to our legs and we're not sort of being cut off at our feet. So now that we've changed up for fall fashion, it's also a good time to think about changing up your makeup, no matter where you live in the world. Here I have kind of a fresh face, summery type makeup, and I even have a purpley eyeshadow with a pink kind of highlighter on my eyes. I also have the pink blush on and also a pink lipstick. And you know what? That's great for the easy breezy kind of summer colors of pinks and blues. But what about the rusts and the browns that you may want to wear in the fall? Well, we got to change up our makeup a little bit for that. So let's take a look. So fall and the holiday season also usually calls for a little bit more makeup. After all, a lot of times maybe later in the day or after work, we're going to some kind of a get together. And what I've done with this makeup is I've put on a more brown to go with the colors that I'll be wearing for fall, and also a cream on my eyeshadow. And also I have a deeper kind of peach on my cheeks and my cheekbones. And also I love this kind of reddish orange lipstick that really goes with a lot of the fall colors. And that palette for my eyes, by the way, is from Revlon, and it's 505 Impressionist. And of course, I'll have links at the bottom for the makeup as well. But it's really a difference between the fresh face kind of summer and the more fall and holiday theme. And notice also that I curled my hair for this video using my new hot rollers. And you know what? That's what this is all about. We go ahead and we buy pumpkins for our home, and we put on maybe a fall wreath outside, and we change up the decor in our home. Well, why don't we do that for ourselves? You know, this is the biggest changing season of them all, so let's change up our look a little bit. And as promised, here is our little Yorkie, Hurricane, and a lot of you were worried about him. Well, he's 11 years old, and his eyesight is kind of going a little bit, so we just thought that, you know, doing this once a week with the studio lights probably wasn't all that great for him. So little Hurricane, he's 11 years old, and that makes him 77 years. He's totally a tiny, awesome one. And the thing is, he's got his little puppy cut here from the warmer weather, but when he goes out in the fall and it's cooler, he's got a real bounce in his step, and he's just a happier little guy, and we should take our cue from little Hurricane. In the fall, we should put that bounce in our step. We should show off our beautiful colors, and we should show the world that at any age, we're still rocking it.